He's talking about domestic violence. I've been getting a lot of inboxes and feedback on domestic violence when I did our narcissistic it's how domestic violence. Okay. Girl, look, I'ma give it to you straight, cause I know you worth it. All that crap he keep doing to you, man, I know you don't deserve it. Reality is, we ain't perfect. That's what you keep telling yourself to make you keep tolerating this abuse over and over again. Cause he's telling you that you don't deserve somebody that'll treat you better. But honestly, deep down inside, you know that he just put that all together. That's all in his mind, just a figment of his imagination. I could tell you right now, down to your entire occupation. And matter of fact, I'm gonna use this as my motivation to give you a little bit of education and stimulate your mind as you grow into higher levels and make you know that, man, you could get it all together. All you gotta do is have faith in God and trust in him to put you back together again, feather by feather. Your ego so fly high into the sky, above all of the negativity. Let yourself know, man, I can rise above what he doing to me. I ain't gotta tolerate this abuse. I don't have to take this pain. You every other day constantly calling me out of my name like I'm not who you know that I am. You treat me so bad. You make me so sad. You constantly get mad. Why? Because there's something that's wrong with you, not me. Man, I'm at the point I'm about to start with accepting reality. My reality is not you. My reality is the truth that looks me right in the mirror, that beauty that shines from within, outwardly, my friend, that's my truth. And guess what else? I'm about done and over you. And even though I might still be in a toxic situation, baby, I'm watching Keisha's video, and man, I'm taking those steps to give me a new occupation. Cause for real, your mind manipulation, I can't even take no more. All this crying that you taking me through, look what you got me going through, going crazy over you. These girls steady calling my phone. I just wish they all leave me alone. Truth is, deep inside, I wish I could say so much to you. But all you do is beat me, either mentally or physically, and just keep putting all that stress into me. But guess what? My kids don't need to see it, and neither do I. I'm about to rise above the pain and keep shooting for the stars in the sky. I made that for y'all, and I want y'all to know I didn't even write it. I just freestyled it, and let me know if y'all want to hear more of my poems. But yeah, that's another thing that you could do is write poems, and it will help you so much to express what it is that you feel in your heart. And that was just me feeling the passion for all of those who are in domestic violence situationships or relationships or whatever it is that you're going through. Because baby, that's not love at all. And I'm just letting you know it's not. Real love is tender. Real love is caring. Real love is honest. It's genuine. Real love, you know, feels good. If it hurts, it ain't love. But stay tuned. I'm about to give you the best video, so keep watching.
Hi, welcome to Honorable Women, Inc., where we like to share because we do care. I'm the Care Bear. If you're new to this channel, please comment, like, and subscribe to this channel. We definitely need your support. And make sure you put in the comments down below, subscribe after you subscribe. Thanks so much. Today's video is gonna be about victims. I received so many DMs about please give us more videos about domestic violence and victims and how the victims feel when they're not supported by friends, family, or whomever. So this video is going to be about victims of all kinds. So if you've ever been a victim, whether that's in a DCFS system, whether that is through domestic violence, human sex trafficking.
Firstly, I just want to say, being a victim of domestic violence or human sex trafficking or any kind of victim is an extremely hard thing because you're going through abuse already and you really need the support and the help of, from those whom you love. So when I get these DMs from people who, you know, secretly message me to tell me like, hey, I need you to let, you know, my family, I need you to do more videos to let my family members know like that this is really hurting me. That it's hurting me when I don't get their support. It's hurting me when they're judging me, telling me, you know, why haven't you left him yet? Or why haven't you left her yet? It's hurting me when they don't understand that this person was not always bad. And that's what this video is about. I'm here to tell you that just because a person has an abuser, they're not always bad. In fact, I don't even like to bash abusers. I mainly like to focus on self-love and just the self-sustainability of the person who's actually going through the conflict or the abuse. Because I don't even want to give the abuser that much validation or that much credit. I'm here for you if you're going through it. If you're a victim, just know that I definitely love you and I definitely understand because I am a survivor of human sex trafficking as well as domestic violence. Now, the second thing I want to talk about is how to support your family member when they're going through this type of tragedy circumstances. So one thing I can remember, you know, my first abusive relationship that I was ever in was when I was a teen. And one thing that I definitely remember is how, you know, different people would try to caution me to leave him alone once they realized that he was abusive. But what no one ever stops to think about is this person was not always bad. This person was, you know, this didn't just happen overnight where they just up and became like this horrible person. This whole thing actually is a process and it actually takes time. Sometimes it could happen over a course of a year, sometimes months, sometimes days. It just really depends on a person and how quickly they feel like they can manipulate your mind for you to be convinced that they are the love of your life. So based on that, that's what dictates the amount of time. I want to say that. The second thing I want to say is that most abusers, whether it's a verbal abuser, whether it's narcissistic abuse, whether it's a physical abuser, they usually start out really, really nice, most of them. Now, you do have some abusers that just come straight in the door just being a horrible person. And I'll do another video of you if you like me to, if you want to know about the different types of pimps that exist, because you got your gorilla pimp, and that's usually the one that's just, you know, straight gutthroat, just, you know, come in the door just being, you know, evil. But then you also have your Romeo pimp. So with a Romeo pimp, they're usually the kind that like to be nice to you, take you out, romance you. I'm using that as an example because the same thing applies in this abuse method. So where the abusers with the different types of abusers. And I'm going to have to do another video to just break it down. I'm still going to be doing that series, guys. I'm working on that currently. So just make sure you keep watching and stay subscribed so that you can see the different types of abusers. So that you'll know, ladies, or you'll know, men, when you come in contact with any of these abusers. Because women, men, like anyone, it could be a family member, can be abusers. It's not only men who are abusers. So with that being said, you know, the person will come in like kind of like the Romeo pimp, and they'll kind of swoop you, you know, sweep you off your feet, give you nice gifts, just be real loving, real kind to you. You know, the abuser I had used to write me love letters. You know, he would buy me things. And I remember the very first time that he actually put his hands on me and
it was just such a traumatic experience for me, because after he put his hands on me and after he choked me because I was looking at someone walking down the street, and then dragged me to his apartment. But after that incident happened, you know, a lot of people jokingly look at the movies with the views, or they watch the Lifetime movies. I love Lifetime, by the way. Love it. Another movie that I love that I feel like really depicts real abuse and how it really goes down is What's Love Got to Do with It? Love, Tina Turner. But a lot of people, you know, they don't believe, like if they never went through that, they think, oh, that's just a movie. No, that is exactly how it happens. And that was exactly how it happened to me. A lot of times, like, the person will, like, be real, real nice to you and wonderful, and they'll buy you a gift, and that confuses you usually, because it's like, okay, what do I do with this? And then they're like, you know, are you gonna leave me like the last person did? Or are you gonna leave me like the last sucker I done made famous? Like, that is the famous line of What's Love Got to Do with It, and it's one of my favorites because it is so true. I've been told that by abusers, like, so I guess you're gonna leave me now, just like everybody else did. And I'm thinking, you think? Absolutely. Like, as soon as I'm strong enough, yes, I'm gonna leave you. But what y'all gotta realize, like, as family members, and I'm just speaking in general, not here to bash anybody, make anybody feel bad, but I need you to understand that I'm definitely here for the victims, and I'm here so that I can just educate everyone. But for the family members, y'all gotta understand, this man or this woman wasn't always an awful person. This person used to probably take them on trips. This person used to buy them nice perfume or nice cologne. This person, you know, was the one telling them, I'll never leave you, I'll always love you. And this person was the one doing that pillow talk, telling them all the things that they felt like they wasn't receiving, probably at home a lot of times. I mean, it's not all the times, but sometimes it is that. Like, that's a big reason why they become like victims of domestic violence, or and I'm not making excuses at all, but I'm just being there for my victims. So for any of my victims of domestic violence or human sex trafficking, if you feel me and you agree with what I'm saying, please, please, please let me know in the comments, for real. But yeah, so they really need your support. They need you to love on them. They need you to just stand there. Sometimes it's not always about saying anything. Sometimes it's about just listening and just being an ear, just being a shoulder, just telling them like, hey, I love you. And I'm not saying by any means you're supposed to just watch this happen. No, I don't suggest that at all. In fact, in the incident with me, after a while, my family got involved and they had actually sent the person like to jail and everything. So I'm not saying stand back and just, you know, watch your family member hurt and do all of this, but I'm talking about you supporting them. Now, how you choose to help your family member and treat the situation, you know, that's your own personal choice, because I definitely, like I said, don't say just stand back and don't do nothing. But you can still be supportive to the victim. You can still make them feel your support by just giving them that love. Like, sometimes it's not about, you know, giving you a pain. It's about just being that ear and just being a safe place. And this is something that my pastor taught me because she was a safe place for me to run to. Like, I didn't feel like I could run to anybody, but my pastor was a safe place where I can go, and she, you know, let me lay in her bosom or let me cry on her shoulder. And it was so many times. And, you know, it's so easy for us to be like, man, I'm tired of this person. Like, I don't want to be bothered because they're going to keep going back to him or they're going to keep going back to her. That ain't what it's about. You're not there to judge, because you don't know when you may end up in a toxic situation. And I don't wish that on my worst enemy. But I'm just saying, like, we supposed to support and love one another. And another thing that the person who reached out, they wanted me to mention how hard it is when you have children with the person that, you know, you was in a domestic violence relationship with. That's another hard thing. Because even though you might have an order protection or whatever, you still have to be in some type of, you know, contact, whether that's verbal communication or something. And that's really, really hard. And it makes it even harder when you have your family in your ear, you know, like, oh, you're stupid, or you're, you know, how could you be this dumb? Or you still having something to do with him. And you know good and well, and I'm talking to the victims right now, you know good and well that you don't even, you know, you don't even mess with him like that, or you don't even mess with her like that, or you know good and well that you on it, on your last straw, that you're tired of dealing with a mess, and that you've already thought about ways that you could leave. You already have a whole strategy in your mind about how you're about to get this escape plan. Some of y'all already contacted, you know, the hotline for domestic violence. Believe me, I've been there secretly. I have contacted that hotline, and it's very helpful. And I would definitely leave it in the link below. And they help you come up with the tools to get a plan so that you can escape. I definitely want to tell you, if you plan on escaping, do not, if you're in a situation right now, do not let your abuser know that you're gonna leave, because sometimes that can end fatal, okay? And I know of a situation where it did end fatal, and my heart goes out to that family, because I just don't want that to happen to anybody else. So that's why I definitely want to mention, like, make sure that you do not tell them that you are planning to leave, and make sure you secretly put those bags or whatever. Sometimes you can't even take a lot of stuff, and they'll tell you that. You know, when you call the hotline, the domestic violence hotline, they will let you know, you know, get what's most important, your ID, you know, sometimes just money, sometimes just gather the kids up. You can't always take everything. And I don't know why I felt led to just mention that just now, but because I felt led, I'm definitely going to mention whatever guys give me to mention to you all. Like, whatever is important to mention, I'm going to definitely mention it to you all. So, yeah, just want you to be more supportive. And if you came across this video, even if you're not a victim, like, maybe you're just a family member and you know someone who is hurting, it's meant for you to watch this video, for real. This is a message for you. I honestly believe that this is a message for everyone. If you got a sister, okay, if you got a brother and they in a abusive relationship where they woman just constantly beating them up or tearing them down mentally, and you really don't want them with that woman, or you really don't want them with that man, because I already know how it is, that's how it was with me, please do the opposite of what you feel. Because, you know, by you yelling and screaming, leave them alone, leave them alone. Don't be with them. I don't want you with my brother, I don't want you with my sister. That's not gonna work. It's just gonna keep pressing them and pushing them closer to them. That's exactly what it's gonna do, okay? Now, if you want some real advice, what I would suggest is not to say a word. Love up on your sister, love up on your brother, love up on your daughter. Get them love. Get them a hug. Sometimes you don't even have to say a word. I say all the time, if you believe in a higher power, if you believe in God, then pray. Pray. Pray for a change. Pray for a difference. And sometimes when you pray, you don't have to say a word. It's all in your energy. When you get them a hug, next thing you know, for whatever reason, they ready to leave this person. The next thing you know, for whatever reason, they coming to you for advice. You don't even have to come to them, like, lead this person, and all of that stuff. Now they come into you like, mom, like, mama, help me, daddy, I'm ready to lead this person. Like, what do I do next? So I just feel like it's very important to just mention those things. I didn't want to even spend that long on the topic, but you see that, how passionate I am about it, because that's something I definitely went through, and that used to aggravate me. I hate to say that, but I have to be, you know, real, as I'm always authentic. You know, I feel like this should be a channel where you could come and you could hear the truth, you know, in the most authentic way. Of course, I'm gonna keep it classy, but I'm gonna give it to you real and raw advice, like the stuff that other people would be too afraid to speak about. That's what I'm on here to speak about. So if you have anything that you would like for me to mention? I had a look. Some of my throat, guys. Sorry. Make sure that you definitely DM me. You know, reach out. Put it in the comments. And I will definitely make an entire video about it because I'm here for you. This whole channel is for you. And without you, this will be pointless. But I just want to make people aware of the things that's constantly hurting people. Give me 1 second, guys. The next thing that I want the family members and the friends to know of the victim is how the abuser manipulates the victim into thinking that, you know, they have this strong bond, and which I spoke about it in a recent video called Narcissistic Abuse. So if you haven't seen that video, definitely watch that video. But they bond with them and they use manipulation to bond with them with anything. It could be concerning anything, really. Something as simple as them having abandonment issues, or something as simple as, you know, both of us lost our mom at an early age. Or they can just use something as simple as, you know, maybe they don't feel like they have any support of the family. So then the abuser will say, well, you have me. All you have is me. And then they bond with them in a close bond. Excuse my hands, guys. I've been like doing all type of art. I mean, I paint murals and all of that stuff and makeup and everything. But they bond with them like that. And when they bond with them in that way, it creates this almost unhealthy, very unhealthy and very strong bond. And it's very hard to just pull away from that. It's extremely hard. It's not like a normal relationship. It's like, you know, pain mixed with the feel good, as I like to call it. And a lot of victims, some may admit it, some may not, but I'm here to tell you the truth, you know, so that you can really get a clear understanding on why they can't just leave this person. Because it's that love that they give them combined with that, you know, I hate to say it, but unfortunately, the abuse. And they don't understand, like, no, they don't like the abuse. I'm not saying they like the abuse at all, but what I'm saying is that they don't understand why somebody who's supposed to love them so much could abuse them, or how they could abuse them in the name of love like this. Like, how can all of a sudden this person, like, man, you just loved me yesterday. You just told me you loved me yesterday. You just gave me a hug yesterday. You know, you just said you was gonna always be there for me yesterday. And now today, you blacking my eye. Now today, you choking me, you slapping me. Now today, you talking to me reckless, calling me out my name, everything in the book except what my name is. I don't understand how that could be so. And this is what's going on in the mind of the person that is happening to. Okay, so a lot of times we have to just realize that everything is not about us, you know? And I feel like it's just important to get that victim that love and that mental support that they need so that they could get out of this toxic. That's why it's called the toxic relationship, because it is toxic. It's toxic mentally and it's toxic physically. And it's toxic even spiritually, because some abusers don't even want you going to church. I went through that one as well. Or even if it's not church, maybe you're a Muslim, or, you know, whatever it is for you, whatever that looks like for you. Some abusers don't even want you going there. They get so controlling and they just want to isolate you from everything that you know to strengthen you, that normally would strengthen you. They will isolate you from those things. And now all of a sudden, you know, it's just you and them. So when it's just you and them, you know, in the abuser's, in the victim's mind, they'll think like, man, I don't have anybody else. Like, I gotta just accept this. They may not verbally say that to you, family members and friends, but I'm telling you like it is. You know, like it is, for real. Like, they may not verbally say that, but I'm telling you that that's what they're thinking. This is a thought that I had. I gotta just deal with what's going on with me and this person, because I don't have any support. Everybody that I look to for support, they either judging me, or they either, you know, downing me, or they don't even care at all. But the ones who do care, it's like they judging the situation, or they're judging me as a person. And I don't want nobody looking at me as being dumb, because I know good and well that I'm not stupid. It don't have anything to do with stupid. That's another thing I want to educate you guys on. I'm glad that I just mentioned that. Stupidity. It has nothing, absolutely nothing to do with being stupid. And you can research it if you want to as well. These people play mad games. They are mass manipulators. And that's how you will see someone that's highly educated. Or you made me look at me now, like, you know, because a lot of you knew me back then, a lot of you didn't. But you may look at me now like, how did you go through this? How did you go through all of that? It does not matter. You could be highly educated. You could be a doctor, a teacher, a lawyer. It could happen to anyone. Because it's not about how smart you are, how smart you are as a person. It's more just about educating yourself on what to expect, you know, from people like this. That's why I do these videos. Because a lot of people are not aware. So you could be highly educated and end up in one of these relationships unaware, and you have no knowledge on it, and you might not catch on because they play so many mind games. They are so manipulative, and you may not even know what the heck happened to you, or how did you even get here, like, or who to even reach out to. And you being a highly educated person will actually make you want to really be quiet more, to be honest. The more highly educated you are, the more quiet you will want to be about something like this. The more you won't want to let people know, because you will feel like, I don't want to be foolish. I don't want to seem foolish. And enough is enough with that. It's not about being foolish. You know, I'm so down to earth. I look at all of us like we're all in the same boat. Whatever that is, it could have been me. You know, it's a song that said, could have been me, with no shoes, no clothes, all of that. Anything could be you. Anything could happen to any one of us if it wasn't for the grace of God. So I don't look at it like, you know, oh my goodness, like this person is this, this person is that. I'm always trying to see, what can I do? How can I help? And I caution you to be the same way. Like, we all need to try to see, what can we do? How can we help the next person? You know, because if you end up in that situation, or if you've already been in that situation, you know, just like I know, help is definitely needed. A shoulder is definitely needed. A hug is definitely needed. Look at my eyes right now. Like, I got on makeup, but I told you, I'm so authentic about this. Some of my eyes, like, it's still kind of black. That was from abuse that I went through. Getting hit in the eye so many times. And you look up, you just, you know, it's kind of black. And I'm not ashamed of it. I call it my war wounds. My war wounds, guys. because I feel like without that, I wouldn't be who I am today. I thank God for everything I went through. Another story that I got. One time, you know, the abuser that I was with was dragging me down an alley. Okay? And he was kicking me. And I started to pray. This is why I tell y'all, prayer works. Prayer works. I'm going to say that in every single video. I'm going to say it until you just really hear it. And like I said, you know, I'm not here trying to beat nobody over the head with what I believe in. Because as long as you believe in something, you know what I mean? But I personally believe in God. And I know it to be true that prayer definitely works.
I just like this.
Because I prayed, like, Lord, please help me. You know, and he proceeds to kick me, like, he started to kick me, like, right in my face. This man was beating me, like, so bad, y'all. And he started to kick me, and he was kicking me in my shoulder. But when he went for my head, he couldn't kick me in my head. And I thank God for that, because had he kicked me in my head, I would have had all types of concussions. But I done had bloody noses, black eyes. You know, police was always called. And what did I do? The same thing that a lot of victims do, is I would send the police away. Like, the neighbors or whomever witnessed the abuse would call the police, and I would send them away. And the reason why is because I felt like I really loved this person. And I felt like, you know, that compassion that I had in my heart wouldn't let me put this person behind bars, or wouldn't let me take action of any kind. So I just think that it's important for y'all to also just realize that, and this is just me speaking from my own personal experience as the victim. another thing that I definitely want to mention and I want you to definitely pay attention to is watch how you speak about this to your family member. This is so important because honestly, depending on how you address this situation, you could make it worse, and you definitely don't want to make it worse. That goes back into me just saying, like, be careful how you talk to them. I don't want you to feel like you got to walk on eggshells, but like I said, just be a shoulder or just that support that they need. That is so, so important. Congratulate them on baby steps. The baby steps that they take is so important. Like, if you notice that, you know, they didn't talk to them for a day, that's something to be like, hey, congratulations. Pat them on the back for that, for small achievements. You know, small achievements make it, make great achievements in the end. So you definitely want to pat them on the back for the little things that they do. Even if you just notice that they're trying, you know, to love themselves more, or they're trying to just not really deal with them, whatever it is that they're telling you that they want to do, just support it, guys, for real. Like, you will be surprised at the difference that that could make with the victim. It could make a huge difference just to feel that love and support. Another thing is I want you to pay attention to the cries of the victims, and that's globally. Don't matter who you are. Recently, there was a young lady on Facebook. I won't say her name because right now everything is under investigation, but she definitely knows who she is. And I definitely shared her story on my page. But there was a young lady on Facebook who was just raped by a man. And it was a very awful and terrible situation. And I know a lot of you may have heard about it. Some of you may not have heard about it. But the point that I'm trying to make is her cry for help was ignored by so many. I mean, yeah, she received the ones who supported her, like me. You know, I was happy, more than happy to share, because I always try to spread the awareness. But there were some who, you know, didn't believe it, and they was not there. So how can you say something didn't happen when you were not there? And we have to start standing together, especially women, the LGBTQ community, you know, all of us as a whole. We need to just stand together and don't be so quick to say this didn't happen. We need to start feeling like maybe it did happen, and let's, you know, not have a blind eye to the situation. My heart goes out to you. I love you so much. I would do everything I can to support you if you're watching. But we don't want to have a blind ear to that, because that's a lot of things that happened to me. Like I said, even when I was being beat up, like, a lot of people had a blind eye to it. I mean, I remember even people coming out the streets, you know, neighbors or whomever, like, that would be in the streets, in the alleys or whatever, while I was being beat severely. And, you know, they would want to help, but a lot of people are afraid to try to help. So, I mean, we need more people that'll stand up, rise up against violence, rise up against things that you know are not right. If you know it's not right, you need to stand up, because you want somebody to stand up for you. You want somebody to rise up for you. You want somebody to love you in a time like that. And even if you're afraid, like, I promise you, it's something you could do. Like, even if you're afraid, like, let's say you don't want to really say nothing on your Facebook, whatever, you can always inbox her, like, man, I love you. Like, if there's anything you need, you know, I'm here for you. Whether that's a rad to the doctor, a lot of people don't know, but after you go through something as vicious as being raped, you gotta go through kits. And I've been raped multiple times before, especially being a victim of human sex trafficking. You have to go through, you know, date rape kits and everything at the hospital. You gotta take a whole bunch of pills to make sure that you, you know, did contract a lot of these diseases, or something even like really, really big while you was out there being raped. And it's just a whole thing that you have to go through. And I love all the advocates that we have out there, because I remember one time I was raped and there was an advocate. I don't even remember her name, but she stood with me, and she was with me in the hospital room through all of the traumatic trauma, all of that I went through, with crying and tears and everything. So definitely, I definitely stand for advocates like that. And If you're located in Chicago, you need somebody to be by your side or whatever, definitely reach out to Honorable Women, Inc. We definitely care about you. We care about everything that you're going through in this traumatic experience and in this time. My heart goes out to you, definitely. And if there's something specific that you want to hear me talk about, please, please, please don't hesitate to let me know. When you're involved in a situation where you got family involved, that makes it even harder. So to answer the person's question who DM'd me about, she wanted to know, like, how can she handle the situation where she still has to let her abuser see her children? That's a tough one, because a lot of times what they do, these abusers come out wonderful to the kids, and the children don't really understand, because they just see, you know, this person is my mom, this person is my dad, whomever the abuser is, they see them as a wonderful person. They are very good at masking this behavior, and they come off so well as that beautiful person to everybody else except you. And you sitting up there wondering, how can this person hurt me like this? But then they so wonderful with the kids. I say, you could do what the law allows. Like, you know, if they have rights to see the child, I would never say deny those rights. But at the same time, do what it takes to keep yourself safe. I wouldn't be meeting up with them alone. You know, I would make sure I have at least 2 or 3 people with me if I have to go take them to meet up somewhere with the kids. Or I may not even meet up with them at all. I would even have someone else to just drop the kids off to the location to see them. But I would say avoid that contact any means necessary, especially if a person is stalking you, harassing you, you know, still trying to be in contact so that they can hurt you. Like, you don't need that. You don't need that negativity. It's time to live and work on you so that you could be free mentally, spiritually, and free in every way possible. Like, you gotta learn how to live again without this person. And it's hard because they try to make you need them in such a way that you may feel like you can't, you know, you won't live again. I have a life without this person. But I'm here to tell you, you can live again, you can sleep again, you know, you could do the things that you love again without this person. Yeah, it may take some time, but you can definitely do it. And I'm here to coach you through the whole process. I don't care if you come to my DM every day asking me questions. I'm here to answer those questions, because I know what it feels like to be mentally trapped, you know, in a toxic and unhealthy situation where you just feel so burnt down and so beat down, where you don't want to get out the bed in the morning, where you just want to cuddle up and just be alone and be left alone. And you don't feel like you have anybody to relate to you, or anybody who understands what you're going through. I'm here to tell you that I understand. I've been there. I had to get through those moments. I laid on the altar at church crying, okay? Crying like, God, please help me I do anything. Just please help me get out this situation. And just like I, you know, I say in most of the videos that I do, God definitely did help me get out that situation. But it took some time. It wasn't an overnight thing. Sometimes I went through abuse after abuse after abuse before I finally was able to escape it all. So my heart goes out to you, and don't ever give up on you. I'm here to tell you, sisters, you know, brothers, if you're going through it, don't ever give up on you. You know, every day that you wake up and you still breathing, it's another chance for you to change your outcome, for you to change how you're doing everything. You can change how you want your next moment to be, to your next day, to your next year. You know, write the vision, make it plain. Write those things down that you want to change, and start making those healthy steps going towards that change so that you can start to see a difference. And even if it's one thing, let that one thing be a glorious occasion. You know, I often go and speak to people, but I also have clients that I personally mentor and talk to about these types of situations. And one of the things I tell them is, pat yourself on the back. Dust your shoulders off, you know? You gotta pat yourself on the back for everything that you do going forward towards that change and just towards a brand new you. I don't care if it's one thing. If you was able to get out of bed this morning without crying, yay, kudos to you. You know, you've already made that first step. If you take a walk, and usually you don't want to go anywhere, you made that first step. If you didn't answer that man or that woman's calls for one day, you made that first step, and you can do it. And I'm here to coach you through the process and cheer you on through the process. I'm definitely rooting for you. You definitely can do it, and you definitely will do it. You know, just hang in there and keep that strength. And to the family members, make sure y'all encouraging them. Make sure y'all stand by they sad. Make sure y'all giving them hugs, because they definitely need all that love and support from you. They need you to love up on them. And I'm talking about the victims. You know, they need you to love up on them. Every chance you get on their nerves with the love. Like, make them say, like, what? Like, okay, I don't need all of that. Like, when they saying that means you're doing a good job. When they like, okay, I don't need all of that support, whatever. But what you want to do is you definitely want to put in a man, like, but you want them to remember, because they may go back to them. And if they go back to that abuser, you want them to remember in their head, my mama loved me, my sister loved me, my brother loved me, my uncle loved me, my cousin loved me, my pastor loved me. That's what you want to stand out in their minds, because I'm telling you, the abuser definitely put in their head that they don't have anyone else but them. You know what I mean? Even if you don't have nothing else, but look, God loves you. Jesus loves you. That too. You know what I mean? Like, but you definitely just, whatever you're doing, let it be some positive energy. Because I'm telling you, as a victim and a survivor of the abuse, we had enough negativity. We don't need it. We don't want the negativity. I'm speaking on behalf of all the people that contact me every single day. We don't need that negative energy. We trying to, you know, live healthier lives. Y'all like my ponytail? But we trying to live healthier lives and trying to move forward. And the way that you could help us move forward is just to be supportive. And, you know, make sure you share this video. Because you may not know who may need to hear it. Maybe you don't need to hear it. Maybe you got years of being a survivor of abuse, of domestic violence, of human sex trafficking. But maybe somebody else needs to hear it. And maybe their family members need to hear it. I mean, it could possibly save a life. That's how serious this is. And, you know, I'm always thinking like, man, what can I talk about in these videos? What can I talk about in these videos? You know, because I just have so much information, and it's like I want to talk about so many different things to y'all, but I need y'all support. Even me, I need the support of the communities, you know, global support, so that the awareness could get out, and so that we can all take a stand as women, and just to be like, you know what, I am not ashamed. You know what, I was in an abusive situation when I was a teenager. Or maybe you're in an abusive situation now that you're about to get out of after watching this video. You know, I just want us to take a stand as women. And whatever men are watching, you too. My heart goes out to you. Believe me, it goes out to you, because the men get abused too. You got narcissistic women. You got narcissistic parents. You got narcissistic whoever. So my heart definitely goes out to you as well. And I just want to tell you, you deserve so much better than that. You deserve so much more than that. Whoever you are, you don't have to tolerate that abuse. You don't. You're so much greater than what they say you are and who they say you are. You have gifts and talents that you probably haven't even discovered yet. If someone had told me that I would be on here talking to y'all right now, I wouldn't even have believed them back then, because I was so, you know, just burnt down and just beat down with all the abuse and all the negativity that I was surrounded with. Sometimes you got to clear out your circle too. That's another thing. These friends that mean you no good, cut them off. Cut them off. You don't need to even say nothing about why. Just cut them clean off. And the reason why I'm telling you that is because you need less negativity and more positivity. You need less darkness and more light. You know? So the more light that you can get, the more encouragement you could get, that's what I'm telling you right now. That's what you need to surround yourself with. Positive quotes. You telling yourself every day when you wake up in the morning, positive things to help you fight
against all the negativity that you surrounded with. And even if you saying, you know what, Miss Walker, don't nobody encourage me, don't nobody care. Guess what? You do got one person that care. I care because I sat up here and I made a video just for you who's watching. I cared enough to make a video, even if you are the only one who watched this video. And you could DM me, like I said, I mean that sincerely from the bottom of my heart. I know that Valentine's Day is coming up. That's a very sensitive time for a lot of people. And some people stay in toxic situations and toxic relationships just so that they could get a gift for Valentine's Day. If it means that much to you, I get your gift. You know what I mean? Like, you don't need to stay in an abusive situation, abusive relationship, just so that you could be happy for 2 minutes. It's not worth it. It's not worth your life. And you don't know if the next time that you're with this person, if they could really end up really trying to take your life. Because it's happening every day. I know so many girls that died on the streets from human sex trafficking. I know of so many people that died on the streets of Chicago, was brutally murdered from domestic violence, from the hands of someone that who claimed to love them, who family and friends was like, you know, we didn't even know this was happening. That's why I say just be that shoulder, be that love, be that support, so that it won't be like, we didn't even know this was happening, but a person will feel safe enough to come to you and feel like you are that safe place where they can come and tell you, look, I'm going through this. I don't know how to tell you this, but I've been feeling a lot of love from you. And they just break down crying on you and tell you flat out, like, I'm being beat on. Like, I thought that it was cool. I justified it because he give me gifts all the time. He tell me he love me all the time. Well, she give me gifts all the time. She say she love me. But I'm being kicked. I'm being choked. I'm being smacked. I'm being talked to, you know, in ways that's not the way that I should be being talked to, period. And that's what you want to be. And like, if I could just be that light and shine, all I want to be is a light bulb today, for real. I want to be a light bulb. You know, I'm making this is my life's mission, to be a light bulb, to end human sex trafficking, but also my life's mission is to be a shining light to all of you. So whomever needs me to shine, let that light so shine before men. That's my prayer to God, that I can encourage you to know that, man, I love you. Whoever you are watching this, man, I'm here for you. Man, I support you. You know what I mean? Like, for real, like, it's nothing phony about this. But anyways, what do? At the end of all our videos, I want to give you a big Care Bear hug, and let me know if you want me to make more videos pertaining to abuse, or if you want me to make a video like for, because I know Valentine's Day is coming up, so you know, all you got to do is DM me and tell me what you want the video to be titled, and I would definitely, definitely do so. Love you guys. Bye.